हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल. दिस इज योर फ्रेंड एडवोकेट प्रतिभा झा. एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक ऑन समथिंग व्हिच कुड बी रियली हेल्पफुल टू यंग गर्ल्स हु गेट स्टक इन दिस थिंग दैट शुड आई बी इन अ रिलेशनशिप और नॉट. ऑल्सो दे डोंट वॉन्ट इट बट दे फील वेरी प्रेशराइज्ड. सी आई हैव ऑल्सो अडल्टेड एंड देन नाउ आई एम अडल्ट. We all go through that teenage years. The dilemmas are there. Sometimes you are not able, a lot of time you are not able to figure out when you are in that stage. You need somebody elder to guide you. You need somebody elder to just consult you and talk out so that you can have your mental clarity and you can come up with a good decision. After all, at the end, the decision making is yours because you have to bear the responsibility of whatever choice you take in your life. So, while I was reading somewhere, I got stuck on this quotation. The status of a woman is measured by the marriage she is into, and the status of a man is measured by his career heights. And this is something which I found very, very, very backward. Really, as a woman myself who is very ambitious, I do not believe that my status in the society should be, I don't entitle anybody, that my status in the society should be measured by my marriage. Because I am a woman, because of my gender, my ambition should be confined and the real goal of my life should be to get married. As a modern woman, I really don't agree to this concept, and I have come across this mail regarding this young teenage girl who has just passed her class 12 and she is stuck in this phase in which there is a guy who is constantly pestering her to get into a relationship with her, and her friends are like, oh, he's so good, he's so caring and all of that, and she just don't want to be in that relationship. And I won't be disclosing the name of the person because of the confidentiality reason, but I thought this video I should definitely make. Quite recently I just made a video in my own life when I was stuck in such a situation, and my friends advised me that you should not be with somebody just because you are so pressurized with about anything, or you should not just be committed just because the guy claims to love you. And I really carry forward with that advice for my own life, and I found it really very helpful, and it has shaken off a lot of burden from my head, because I am a person who bear the responsibility of my all actions. So when I am decisive that no, I don't feel about somebody, I just don't have to entertain because of somebody's feelings towards me. I'm having a valid reasons of not entertaining that person. Now, when I read through this mail, I found it very simple for me because I have crossed that age. I have that maturity level. But then I know that when I was in that age, I know we overthink a lot. I was been there, done that, actually been in very similar situation. So I know that it could be very confusing. And yes, you have just graduated. This person has just graduated her class 12. So you are in a phase in which you'll be entering your college, which is in itself a very overwhelming situation, because we all plan for our college life and how we will be living our college life. Probably you are 18, this girl is already 18, so you have just now entered, blossomed into adulthood, and people have their plans and aspirations about exploring their own life, and making a boyfriend is not in the list of a lot of people, right? But yeah, when you have written me in the letter, I mean in the mail, that your friends are pestering. Honestly, to be very honest, I was in this similar situation in which a lot of pressure I have faced from my female friends, like, oh, he's very cute, he's very caring, nobody will love you like how he does, and you should say him a yes. I know how it feels when you have been friends for years and then they are trying to convince, and worst it becomes situation, because I know how a lot of friends, they try to pressurize in making decisions. I was in the situation also that if I don't say yes to that fellow, my friend, she won't talk to me. So I know, you know, it might sound that you can just discard your friend's advice, but that situation could be very stressful because you don't want to lose your friendship in first place. Also, you don't have a clarity, you love that person or not. Plus, in this mail, the best part was you have the clarity. You don't want a relationship, you don't love him, and the answer is quite simple. You don't love him, you don't have to be with that person. Very, very simple. This is forever. This is an advice forever which you can take as an elder sister, advice from elder sister. If you don't love somebody, you don't have to be with that person just for the sake that they claim to love you. Now see, things could become very overwhelming at your age because as I already said, we all have crossed that teenage years, and how it works, functions, a lot of you, I think Gen Z are more open generation, your generations are more open, you people are more close to your parents and talk about everything in detail, which unfortunately my generation was in the initial stage. I am also Gen Z, but initial Gen Z, okay. But the modern Gen Z, I mean, like, if you have just graduated your 12th currently, you're very, very fresh Gen Z. Your generations are more close to parents. And all these topics are openly discussed, okay? So you can discuss with your parents about these things that, there's a guy who is pestering to me that he claims to love me, but I just have no feelings towards him. And I think your parents' advice would also be to, you know, have a communication with the guy and just clarify him that you are not interested, and not to get worried with those friends who are pestering you to be in that relationship. First of all, let me make things very clear to you. Your relationships are your choices. It should not come out of pressures that your friend finds somebody cute. Tell your friend to go and date that person. You don't have to date that person. And also, you don't have to date somebody until and unless you are ready. That's very cute point which I learned very late in my life. That you don't have to do anything until and unless you are ready about those things. You don't want to do it. You should not get under the pressure of influence and then do that. There's nothing wrong in not wanting to have a boyfriend, okay? There's nothing wrong in denying somebody's proposal. It's not like rejecting a proposal. You have a choice to say a no to people and they have to respect your choice. This is very simple. If this classmate is your, this person is your classmate, which you have mentioned that he's your senior, not your classmate. If he pesters more, this is not a drastic step. People feel that this is a drastic step. Just tell him very politely, listen, I'm really not interested in you. Thank you for having those genuine feelings towards me. But you need to know that you just can't force anybody to love you, or you just can't demand anybody to get into a relationship with you. Okay? Very good. If he agrees, well and good. If he doesn't, just say him, if you pester me again, I am definitely going to involve my parents and I am going to raise this issue to the dean or principal of your college. Okay, in case you have entered your college, dean principal of your college. Okay, this is a step ahead. People think that this is a very serious step, but this is a very small step that you can take. Okay, he will back off. Okay, if he be like, no, you just say anybody. Okay, you just say him, okay, fine. No problem, I just warned you up about this thing. If it happens again, because I don't approve of it, if it happens again, I am going to involve it. And this is not just warning to scare you off. This is exactly what I'm doing about you. And to your friends, just tell them, listen, it's my life. I'll decide when to date, whom to date. You find him cute, you can keep him for yourself. And in case you just want me to date that person, I just can't follow your footstep. And in case if you pester more, I'll tell my parents to tell your parents that you are pestering me into all these things. Obviously, these things will definitely, because the people who would propose you would be of your age, probably 1-2 years elder. Okay, so generally they'll be scared about this thing. They'll not approach to you. They'll also apologize to you in case they offend you, because all these things, you know, pestering somebody is a sort of pressurizing. They don't know what they do to your mind. I mean, like, you overthink, you sit, you decide, you confront about things, you write a mail, you have written a mail to me. Definitely it is something which has been stuck to yourself. So I would definitely say there's no age to love, but it should happen by your free will. It should not, like, everybody wants out of you and you should out of pressure. So if you want to date somebody, happily you date, but it should be your choice. You don't want a boyfriend, nothing to be ashamed about, nothing to worry about, and nothing to be threatened about it. You can't say a no, and it would be rude. Obviously it might look rude for time being, but it's good for you. You are the one, I'm saying, you're very young now. Okay, you have your entire career ahead of you. Okay, in case if you even get involved with this guy with no feelings with you, you will have that thoughts repeating that you're just pleasing that person, and trust me, eventually it won't work out with that person and you would be wasting a lot of time. When you make things very clear, you'll have a mental clarity and you'll be at a better place. You'll have a lot of peace within yourself, and people who are honest, they, trust me, they sleep with a lot of peace. Okay, they sleep very happily with a lot of peace. And yeah, it's your choice to not have a boyfriend. So, kudos, girl. Go, girl. That's it in my video. I hope I helped you. And don't let people to decide for your life. At least for your dating choices, your personal choices, your preferences in life. I mean, if you let others, decide, when things go wrong, nobody would take that blame. It would be you who would be living those scars. Or if it turns out to be good, it's just a prediction. But yeah, it would be all probability, not your choice. So if you want to lead your life by your choice, definitely your steps should be your thought up. Things can go well, things cannot go well. But it should happen out of your choice, that yes, you want that. You are ready for the uncertainty. It's not that somebody else wants that of you. Okay? And yeah. Stay happy. And don't overthink about it. You're doing great. Bye-bye. And keep writing to me.